Can any of you hear me? Where are you? You there. Have you seen my squad? We were all in the little Alkosh, part of the Dominion fleet sailing for Kanathi's Roost. Then a hurricane blew up out of nowhere. Sails tore, hulls cracked, and we were thrown into the ocean. I ended up here. I can't find the rest of my squad. I thought I heard one of them calling out, but the ocean twists up sounds. If they're wounded or pinned down, could you keep an eye out for my soldiers? They answer to Edelus, Onglon, and Nistel. Two of us can cover more ground. I'm sure my squad made it to shore alive. Dominion Marines constantly defy the sea's attempts to drown us, but hurricanes are another matter. I fear my squad is banged up worse than I am. Our ship's hold was packed full of an old Bosmer healing remedy. The labels say Torchbug Treacle, but Marines call it Glow Juice. The wrecked scattered bottles across the beach must be what brought out the Aelids. Squat creatures made of teeth, claws, and endless hunger. I've heard their cries up and down the beach since I came too. Their sweet tooth is bigger than their walnut brains. I saw one of the stupid things swallow a whole bottle of blow juice. Good luck. Do me a favor. If you find them before I do, tell them the ocean hasn't killed me yet.
Who are you? Were you part of the fleet? Alive? Good. That's good. Wave smashed me against the ship. Cracked a few ribs. Not the best feeling. Tastes like sandals boiled in mint perfume. But if it knits my ribs, I'll drink the whole bottle. Good. I'll find Sergeant Firion. Go. Get them back safe.
I lost a lot of friends in that storm. Give me some good news. I saw her swept overboard in that damn storm. Held on to the rigging long as I could, but it tore the skin off my palms. If I can't hold a weapon, I'm useless to my squad. Do you have any bandages? I lost my kit to the sea. Glow juice? Used to think this stuff was only good for practical jokes on snowy days. Once I can heft Spleen Shanker, I'll push through the beach and find Sergeant Firion. How about you? Hope they appreciate their good fortune when you find them. I can get inland after I rest. Fight with purpose.
Nonetheless, Ifra, I'm glad you came by. Have you seen any other Marines along the beach? She's alive. I suppose that's some luck amidst all this wreckage. Can't say the same for my leg. If I don't put too much weight on it, I can manage a good hobble. Glow juice? By the gods, it just might. Soon as I can stand on my own, I'll head inland. Lieutenant Gellin dragged me out of the water. He'll want to know Sergeant Virion and the rest of the squad are all right. I think he said something about looking for shelter in a nearby cave, but I was still coughing up sand.
Turns out my squad were the ones who found me. Ever consider a career as a Dominion Marine? You'd make quite a scout. My squad said you were looking for Lieutenant Gellin. Have you found him?
What do you mean?
First, a hurricane blows out of nowhere and destroys our fleet. Then, an able-bodied Dominion Marine is captured and tortured to death? What else was in that cave? Some kind of sacrifice? This is too big for my squad to handle. We need reinforcements. Nistel spotted a beach ship nearby. It looks intact, and she spotted Dominion sailors aboard. We need to combine our forces and find who murdered Lieutenant Gellin. My squad and I need to pull his body out of that damn cave. Would you warn the sailors on that beach ship? They need to know it's not safe to wander around. Wait, take this. I found some glow juice while I was looking for my squad, but they're on the mend. You'll get used to the taste. We'll be along shortly. Watch yourself.
Lieutenant Gellin pulled me out of the water. Owed him my life. Not too late to pay him back.
The crew of that beach ship may be on edge. Let them know you're with the Dominion.
Before the next sun sets, my blade will find a home in the heart of Lieutenant Gellin's killer. May the fates guide me to avenge him.
You want a slick-arsed sea viper or a cabbage-mouth castaway? State your business with the crew of the Prowler. The hurricane killed hundreds of Marines. Why does it matter if one of them died in the cave? Oh. Well, the Prowler is like a hen in a wolf den until she's seaworthy again. Maybe your Marines can prove they're more than two-legged cargo and shiny armor. If they pitch in, I'll consider reinforcements. They up for it? Or are they all talk? And I'm sure they'll be as useful as they were in the hurricane. Should they care to prove otherwise, they're welcome to do actual work patching leaks in the Prowler's hold. Maybe they can locate the replacement helmsman's wheel in all this wreckage. Oh, and our sunsighter. It must have fallen overboard when we beached. Our lookout saw those skink-fingered pirates make off with it. You'll have to get the sunsighter back, any way you can. Sure, talking's easier than working. Well, ask. Barnacles on the arse. They're all sea elves. Malmer, they call themselves. Nothing more than pirates, if you ask me. Some say they have a connection to the water itself, but it's a lie. Anyone can learn weather magic like they do. Captain Jimala uses it to navigate. I could tell you how the sun and stars show the ship's exact position, but none of it matters while it's in the Sea Viper's hands. The pride of the Long Coast. We'll sail for the Dominion as long as they pay us to raid enemy shipping. Joan and Jode, don't let the captain hear you say that. Pirates steal and pillage for themselves. We're privateers, so we do it for whoever pays us. A crucial distinction. Captain Jimala took over the Prowler a few years ago. She's smart, cunning, and deadly dangerous when provoked. She's also luckier than anyone I served. Every ship in the fleet smashed to flinders on Kenarthi's roost. Every ship but the Prowler.
These aren't Dominion sailors. They're privateers. Just our luck. We'll show that old sea cat what Dominion Marines can do. Edelus is the best scrounger in the regiment. If you want, I can send him out to look for a helmsman's wheel. He's on his way. Anything else we can do? Nustellus is good with a mallet as she is with her sword. I can have her patch the Prowler's leaks. She'll have those leaks fixed in no time. What else? Onglorn is our best tracker. He can recover the Sunsider in no time. I almost pity the Sea Viper who's holding on to the Sunsider. Onglorn will recover it soon enough. When it's time for that mangy privateer to make good on his promise. Maybe.
That was fast. All right. There's room on the Prowler for your Marine friends. As long as they work for their meals. I said I'd consider it. Captain Jimala is the only one who can make that call. Something you'll want to hear. You just made the Prowler seaworthy. And Captain Jimala always pays her debts. Go talk to her. She only bites if you give her good reason.
Make sure you check the hull for holes.
Due to your efforts, the Prowler is free to sail once the tide comes in. Those Marines did their part as well. I have no reinforcements, but I offer something better. I know who's killing the Dominion soldiers, and I know how to stop it. Our lookout watched the Sea Vipers drag a Dominion Marine into a cave. Later, he saw your friends remove the Marine's body. If we weren't so short-handed, I'd have ordered his rescue. But three of my own crew were missing. Before we understood the danger, I sent my crew to scavenge among the shoals so we might repair the Prowler. We thought they disappeared, but one just returned, and she tells a harrowing tale. The Sea Vipers happened. Now there's a new storm brewing, and I fear they're the cause of it. Mustengui recovers below. Hear what she has to say for yourself.
The sea vipers are insane! They're trying to create another hurricane! Sir Verkvild and I were scavenging for a replacement helmsman's wheel when the sea vipers ambushed us. They brought us to the island with the beached Dominion flagship. They'd done things there. Terrible things. Those filthy Maurmer dragged my mates up and tied them to these serpent-shaped statues. Then they started chanting, and lightning surrounded them. That's when the storm began to form around the island. Yes, I'm sure of it. It was a terrible sight. The sea vipers were so caught up in the ritual, I slipped free. I tried to grab Sir, but the lightning held him fast. Then one of the sea vipers yanked at him. I saw the Maurmer's wrist glow. The Maurmer wore lodestones on their wrists. It let them ignore those lightning bonds, but I couldn't find any more. So I jumped off the ship and swam for it. Please, don't let them sacrifice my crewmates.
Land. Have we reached land? But the room still spins. Why did I board this accursed ship? The Prowler needed a cook, so I volunteered. First time to travel by sea. Thought all the water would be like the marshes back home. But now even the smell of food. Oh gods, land.
Leave!
Sur and Vorkvild returned just after the skies cleared up. They're a bit damp, but otherwise all right. My lookout says I have you to thank. Then we'll finish repairs and shove off at high tide. Oh, your marine friends fended off sea vipers while you rescued my crew. They're welcome aboard, as long as they want. Perhaps we'll see you at Mistral. You'll always have a place on the Prowler. And Vorkvild. Then we'll finish repairs and shove off at high tide.
Oh. I'm glad we could help get the Prowler seaworthy. If the Sea Vipers are causing any more trouble, the Dominion needs all the ships it can get.